Hello, Super Kids. It's time for quantitative reasoning. I hope you are ready to think. In today's class, we are looking at exercise 9, and we have 3 examples to explain here. In example 1, let's take a look at this sample. In this sample, the symbol shown here represents plus. So let's make use of this plus sign to look for the missing number. If 21 is not there, then you add 9, you add 8, and then add 4, and that will give you 21. If 9 is missing, then you will subtract the sum of 8 and 4, which is 12, from 21 to get 9. If 8 is not given, then subtract the sum of 9 and 4, which is 13, from 21, and that will give you 8. If 4 is missing, then subtract the sum of 9 and 8, which is 17, from 21, and that will give you 4. Still on example 1, let's take a look at the second sample. In the second sample here, the symbol shown here stands for minus. So let's make use of the minus sign to look for the missing number in the sample. If 0 is not given, this 0 is not given, then you will subtract the sum of 4 and 6 from 10, and that will give you 0. If you are looking for 6, then you will subtract 4 from 10 to get 6. If 4 is not given, you will subtract 6 from 10 to get 4. So from this point, let's move on to the second example under exercise 9. In example 2, the symbol shown in this sample represents division sign. So let's make use of the sign to look for the missing number. In this sample, if 4 is not there, if 4 is not given, then you will divide 20 by 5, and that will give you 4. If 5 is not given, divide 20 by 4, and that will give you 5. Okay, let's see what we are going to do if 20 is not given. If 20 is not in the sample, you will multiply 5 by 4, and that will give you 20. At this point, let us move on to the second sample, still under example 2. In the second sample, here, this symbol shown here represents minus. So let's make use of the minus sign to look for the missing number in the second sample of example 1. If 13 is not given, this is what you will do. You will subtract 3 from 16 to get 13. If 3 is not given in the sample, subtract 13 from 16 to get 3. If 16 is not given in the sample, you're going to add 13 and 3, and that will give you 16. From this point, let's now move on to the third example. Under example 3, let's look at the first sample. In this sample, we are working with dots. If you come across 2 dots with a number, you multiply that number by 2. If it is 3 dots, you multiply the given number by 3. If a number is attached to 4 dots, you multiply that number by 4 to get the second number. So let's take a look at this sample. In this sample, we have 5, 2 dots, 10. If you are looking for 10 in that sample, what you do is that you will multiply 5 by 2, and that will give you 10. With this, we have come to the end of our class for today. Spend quality time to watch the video, attempt your quiz, do your assignments, and enjoy your studies. Bye for now.